Hello everyone, welcome back to another new video, and today I will be showing you another chess endgame study where both sides have brilliant moves in an unpredictable game. In the following position, white must play pawn takes g7 to start off the puzzle because moving the rook away from d2 allows black to win the pawn after it captures on g7 with knight to h3 discovered check. Since king to g2 allows queen to f2 and g1 mate, white must let black play queen to e5 check, and black will have a winning material advantage as well as a passed g pawn to boot. Now, knight to h3 check is just a draw because white can move the rook to the a-file if black captures on g7 with deadly consequences, but black's resources are not exhausted, as there is the brilliant move knight to d3 check instead. Because king to e2 or g2 both allow queen to f3. Which is checkmate, or black wins the rook with check respectively. King to g1 is forced, and black can follow up with queen to c5 check. As king to g2 will again lose the rook to a fork after queen to d5 check, white again needs to play the only move king to f1. Because queen to f5 check is just a repeat of the position, and there are still ladder mate threats looming for black, black must continue checking with queen to c1 check, which white can counter with king to e2 protecting the rook. Even though white's king seems to have escaped, black can play knight to f4 check king to e3 queen to e1, forcing the win of white's d2 rook with check at the cost of the knight, and now white must play very accurately in this position. Rook to e3 seems like the best move even to strong players as it saves the rook, but after queen to d4 check, white's g7 pawn will be lost, and the resulting position is a difficult but winning endgame for black because white's h-pawn is too far advanced to set up a fortress. White must continue taking pieces with king takes g4, which doesn't seem to change much after queen to d7 check. But in this position, all of the basic principles are just illusions as white can play the brilliant move king to h5, and queen takes g7 will allow white to sacrifice the rook by force with a stalemate. So black plays queen to f7 check, winning white's rook, but only white's rook because after king to h6 queen takes b3, white can play pawn to h5, as after queen to f7 putting white in zugzwang, white can just promote, and it will be another stalemate. Black must block the g-pawn with the queen, but because white has two pawns instead of one, by advancing the h-pawn to the 7th rank black's queen will be forced out. And all white needs to do now is to keep the king on g6 or h6 when possible under check, and black cannot win no matter how many checks are played. If you want to see more brilliant chess puzzles like this, be sure to like and subscribe for more, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.